Hi, everybody. It's George Foshan, called Realty Best Palos Verdes Homes. It is whatever day it is, middle of November, 2020. This is the latest update on how COVID-19 environment has affected real estate, or has it affected real estate? Let's take a look and see what's going on. Let me move my picture out of the way a little bit. All right. So, first thing to do, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Go to youtube.com/homeispv. We're going to go over the facts. And volume changes up. Sale volume is up. Prices up, both on a dollar per square foot and a gross price level. And supply and demand numbers are still looking pretty darn good. With the ratio of pending sales to new listing volume at 95%. So that's pretty strong. And what we're going to look at right here, let's see if I can freeze this a second. Probably won't be able to, but anyway, you can see what the trend has been over time. What this is measuring right here at the high point is for every 10 new listings coming on the market, 15 existing listings were being sold. That's a super hot market, and this upward trend in the ratio of demand to supply is in part, in fact, probably the only factor that is propelling price appreciation. Now, the market's kind of a living thing. It breathes, it inhales, it exhales, and you know, nothing goes up forever, and we're seeing that since about this time, around the 27th week after Newsom locked us down, you know, the market's kind of taken a breath, but we did have a jump. So we'll see what the next few weeks brings. You know, it's the holiday season too, so things are going to slow down a little bit. So there may be some seasonality in here, but generally speaking, you know, there's been a sweeping improvement in demand supply ratio. So I think that's really interesting. So to digress a minute, a lot of you have heard this already, but it bears repeating. Goodness gracious, don't use those big giant portals to do your home searches. Don't. It's ridiculous. They're not real estate search companies. They are data mining companies. They scrape your personal contact information, what you searched for, how long you searched, how many times you searched, and they sell that information to multiple advertisers on their platforms and multiple real estate agents who pay them for leads. And so if you've ever wondered why your spam calls have increased, why your spam emails have increased, that's probably why. So instead of going to those big giant portals, and you know which ones I'm talking about, use searchhomesinprivate.com. Yes. You will have to register with your email address and cell phone number, but that information goes no further than me. I don't share it. I don't sell it. I don't give it away ever. And you may want to also kind of take a look at this site too, howmanybuyerswantmyhouse.com. Really fascinating technology in that. And then the other thing too, recently the National Association of Realtors has pretty much outlawed pocket listings. Yes, as brokers, we can list properties as coming soon, but it is against the rules. In fact, the penalties are extremely high if an agent shows a coming soon listing. I mean, really high. And the coming soon won't be shown on those big giant portals like Zillow or Realtor.com, as an example. You can't see them, but I've got a hack for that, and you can text me at this number right here to get that hack and be able to get access to the coming soon listings. You won't be able to see them in terms of physically visiting them, but you'll be able to know about them before they hit the active market. All right, folks, that's it. See you next week. Bye for now.